That's what I'm saying, dog. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. It's a party. Time it up. It's a party. Yeah, yeah. It's a party. Time it up. It's a party. It's like a little Mecca. It's like our own little West Side. You know what I mean? In the 818. That's how we do it. We roll with the 818. So this is like a 310 or 213 in the 818. Santa Monica wishes they were here right now. West Hollywood, West LA wishes they were here. Now, guys, this is the place to be. Trust me. Less traffic, good people, and a lot of fun. And a much more homey environment.
Most amazing truck that's here, besides the bacon truck. Those are my two favorites. Their food is just delicious. You know, I usually get the five cheese crepe, and it's just so creamy and it's big. It's nice and big.
She's been waiting for like a half hour.
I know. She is our favorite client in Granada Hill. She absolutely is religious about coming to us. It's amazing. Hitting up all the trucks.
Pupusas and panini.
And garlic fries. And we had flatbread.
Oh, the fry bread is so good.
All right, it's called the Patrolman. It's a burger with blue cheese, bacon, and a cran apple reduction between two donuts. It's good stuff. Two donuts. I had to try it, yeah. Couldn't resist.
Oh my God. How many calories?
I don't want to know. You don't want to know.
So does Christine, so I can't.
Yeah, thanks.
The vegified nachos from the nacho truck.
And what makes it really so good?
It's vegetarian.
For the vegetarians.
It's guacamole. It's spicy. It has black beans, corn, lettuce. The chips aren't like regular like chips. They're like almost kind of pita nacho chips.
They told me they make them fresh themselves, so they're really good.
I think it's doing really good things for the community. The only thing I feel bad about is, for example, my buddy at Frosty Queen. He's getting a little bit hurt. He's been there for many years.
As the food truck started showing up, at first I hated the idea. Didn't want any more competition in the area than need be because of business being down. But kept an eye on it as time went on. And I'm still trying to figure out whether it's helping or hurting us.
They take all the parkings. They make a mess on the streets. They block our signs. They take our customer parkings. And it's been going on at least twice a week. You know, they should go someplace that there is no other restaurants, other pizza place or a bakery. You know what I mean? There is lots of empty spots down the street. They can go there, nobody will complain.
I discovered a lot of people are not on the side of the business owner. They think that the food trucks are the greatest thing on earth.
Some of the business owners, you know, sometimes they don't like us here because, you know, they feel that their business may be blocked or can't be seen from the street. But then there's also another end where other business owners, they love us because now they have the foot traffic here and the possibility of having customers come into their location.
I'm on the Granada Hills South Neighborhood Council, and we have formed a committee to look at the food trucks here and see how we can work this out so that it'll help the business. Well, we're interested in helping the business here in the neighborhood, and we're also very interested in the environment the food trucks have brought. We've never really seen the community come together like it has since the trucks have been here. So we're trying to get the businesses talking to the food trucks and see if we can work out some sort of an agreement where the businesses are benefiting from it, the community's benefiting from it, and the food trucks are benefiting from it.
On Fridays, we've been going down about 10% on deliveries, 20 to 30% on dine-ins and another 10% on the pickup and counter orders.
We got my boy Joey Barafuca here tonight. Hey, Joey! Joey, come here!
This is like being on the streets back home. That's how good it was. Where are you gonna get a hot dog with pastrami on it?
And how was the crowd?
Crowd was great. This place was jamming all night. This truck was happy.
No time to breathe, no time to think, right?
It was great. Food was great. You'll love it. Come on out. You'll love it.
It's tremendous. You know, this street needs this. The city needs it. Some of these businesses should hop on board. So, cheers.
I decided to stay open because of the trucks on the Wednesday and the Friday. I open a little later because they're here till 10, 10:30, 11 o'clock in the evening. And there's so many people on the streets, and that's like free advertising. So I took advantage of it, and I decided to stay open, and it's doing quite well.
We've had so many people walk in that live in the area, that have seen the business, maybe driven by, wanted to come in, but now this is making them walk and see it and come in and experience it. And they realize that we do men, women, children, we're dog friendly. We let people use our restrooms, they can come in here and eat their food. We love it. It's fabulous for us.
Well, as the chamber, we don't have particular authority over the food trucks, but we are pro-business, and we do have members that are business owners, and we want the business community to thrive. So we're trying to work with them. You know, our business owners are trying to work with them. Our residents are trying to work with them.
Businesses that are having a hard time, I don't know. We've had a sense that a few of them are starting to calm down, realize what's going on, and they're trying to go with it. You know, so at least they're trying.
Today we will be handing out samples of purple cupcakes. It's called ube. It's a purple jam.
Samples? You're welcome.
Hi.
Purple jam.
So pretty.
Thank you.
Filipino flavor.
Oh, wow. Thank you very much.
Everyone likes them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
She's getting us to go in here. That's,
yeah, that's, see, that's the key, right?
It's great to be out here and part of the community and all that good stuff.
Right, have you ever seen this place hopping so much?
Never, ever. I didn't even know people came outside around here.
Literally within walking distance of my house. So it just, it feels like a street affair, you know, that a happening.
Granada Hills being that it is probably one of the last bedroom communities in Los Angeles, I think that this is gonna be a, I don't know, I think it's going to kind of be a cohesiveness for Granada Hills and the local surrounding area as well. Last week when I was here, I bumped into probably 10, 15 people I know, and it's just wonderful. It's a good place to come on the weekends, and I love it.
I think with having the food trucks here, it brings the family values together again in the evenings where you would normally have dinner around the table. Now you're having dinner around the food trucks.
How are you walking out on Chatsworth Boulevard with all your hair stuff?
Oh, well, I don't care. I figure I've got 40 minutes to wait. I'm going to go get me some food. And the gourmet trucks are really fun.
And how about Kristen supporting this whole thing?
Oh, she's great. I mean, she makes it available. You can go sit down in the salon. A lot of people just go there and hang out. A couple weeks ago, I met a friend of mine that I've known since college, who has lived out of state and is traveling around the country now. I met her up here. We got food. We went and sat at Kristen's for about an hour and just talked. And it was a great evening, or maybe longer than that. It was a really fun evening.
Step right up, step right up. Louisiana Cajun soul food truck. The one and only Slap Your Mama soul food truck. The name's so nice, you gotta say it twice. Come eat here for the nice meal tonight. There we go.
I'm not here at nights. I have the cameras. I can see how many people going, coming. And if those lunch trucks, they're gonna ruin our business, we're gonna do our best. And believe me, we will win in the long run, that we're not gonna let them come here.
Yeah, because this is, man, it's not so bad if they come in at 6 o'clock, but man, we don't even, none of our customers can park.
Usually they'll either come very, very early to try and reserve a spot for themselves, or they'll end up parked in a red zone or too close to a curb or that sort of thing. So it's certainly created more contention for the limited parking that's available on Chatsworth.
Everybody that comes out here knows that you've got to get here early enough to get a good spot. But they come out, they bring their cars and they park them, they leave them until the trucks come out like 1, 2, or 3 o'clock. Everybody does it. You know, there's a couple of trucks right now that have spots on hold that I can see. So, I mean, it's part of the business, it's part of the game.
I think the Chamber of Commerce is powerless. I don't think they've been able to do anything. I think the problem is growing worse and worse. There are far too many trucks. I think that, again, the city should put a limit upon the number of trucks that can park on any given block.
Obviously, as time goes on, we have to be a few rules and regulations that need to go in just for the safety of people.
I see mother, father holding the kid's hand and running from one side to another side. This is fine. You get lucky over here. If there is a corner street and the lunch trucks are blocking, believe me, they will die.
Part of the concerns are the traffic, you know, the extra congestion, the safety here. The street is awfully narrow. People coming from outside of the areas, you know, what kind of an element is that bringing in? Trash, you know, those sort of things. So I think one day a week's fine. I think 2 days a week is an overkill.
These food trucks are wonderful. They've been a blessing to us because we do the cleaning behind them after they're here. We don't stop at about 3, sometimes 2:30, 3:30 in the morning. This food trucks over here has done for us, for our family, it's helped us out by putting food on our table and paying a few utility bills as my husband wasn't working. Things were really, hit hard times, we really did. And I'm very grateful that they came into our community because they came in at a good time.
The Lord just answered our prayers to go to work, doing the trucks and the cleaning, me going back to work after being out of work for 2.5 years, collecting unemployment till it ran out. And when it ran out, that's when we went to the very bottom. And fortunately, we went back, went to work, started making a little money, being able to pay our bills and
buying food,
and it's worked out real well. And we're very thankful for it. And all the business people say, you know, the street's actually cleaner now than it was when we had the street cleaners going by here.
Is opening day for us, and we have good old-fashioned sloppy joes with fresh daily baked bread. We've got steak joes, shrimp joes, surf and turf joes, which means you have put everything in our fresh bread topped with coleslaw and a secret sauce that we put on top of the slaw with a little bit of horseradish in it. Gives it a kick. It's awesome.
So why'd you get into this business?
That's a good question. It looked like a lot of fun. We always watch the Food Network, and it's pretty much our favorite show. And we saw the big, the great food race. So we said, you know what, maybe one day we can get on that. But in order to do that, we got to get a truck first. So we started with the truck, and then that's our goal.
Why did you choose a trailer instead of a truck?
Because I want to cook in front of people. I think a lot of the truck, you don't see what they're doing inside. I wanted to do something visual. You know, we create a bit of a social scene too, where we go. And, you know, it's an attraction. So, you know, it's visual. We all walk with chef jacket, gloves. It's all top of the line on the food. And, you know, versus doing all the, like a big truck, which is much more expensive to begin with. we wanted to do something sample, and it's a pretty good concept. It's been working well. We've been out here for about 10 months now, and we're pumping. We're out there 7 days a week, 24/7. Yeah.
So, turn it.
We've been in business up for our first week, 5 days officially rolling, and last Friday was given an invite to come out to Granada Hills, and I just got my door slammed off. It was rocking out here last Friday. What I love about it is that, you know, I have my restaurant on wheels. I'm living my dream in a tough economy. The benefit of having a food truck is you're not a brick and mortar. You're not stuck in one location. If you choose a wrong location, you're stuck with it. With a food truck, I could choose a wrong location one night and then the next day be at a different location. So it's all about location. Location, location, location. My truck's name is Philly Please Cheesesteaks. And the reason why it's Philly Please is because when you say it, you gotta smile. So it's Philly Please.
Well, we've had a lot of people and organizations take advantage of the event. Anything from local schools doing fundraisers to local churches. We've had people selling glow necklaces and lightsabers, a dog rescue group, and we've had belly dancers. We've got local musicians, anything from rock and roll to country western.
Is that the Sloppy Joe?
Yep.
What do you think?
I think it's fantastic. It's got so much flavor. Really good.
Did you get the Sloppy Joe too?
No, I got the meatball.
That's a Sloppy Joe.
Sloppy Joe, I guess.
Yeah, it's a Sloppy Joe.
She ordered it.
And what did you think?
It's pretty damn good.
Very much fun.
I love it. I brought my grandkids last week, and they're coming to meet me tonight. So.
Good entertainment.
It's good.
The cost of the trucks vary. If you bought a truck brand new, retrofitted, it can run you anywhere from $130,000 to $150,000, depending on what you put in it. Then you have the wrap, which can run you up to $5,000. Then you have all the licenses and insurances and all that stuff. If you rent it can run you up to $30,000 to $50,000. So for some trucks, it's easier to rent it to get your business established, and then you buy your truck.
Thank you.
The health department hasn't made a visit to this event yet. I've heard rumors that at some point they will. I don't know when that'll be.
I would say the health department should come out and take a look.
Where do you think they are?
They're probably working 9 to 5.
There should be rules and regulations for these trucks as to, you know, how long they can stay in the spot, you know, what they can do on sidewalks. I mean, I'm not allowed to put a sign on the sidewalk, yet these people are able to do business on a sidewalk. So, you know, in that respect, it's not really fair to a guy who's paying DWP bills and gas bills and phone bills and property tax on the property that we own here.
The citizens of Granada Hills are responsible to make the rules and regulations by writing their councilmen and telling them their concerns. And then the councilmen can put forth a bill of some kind. There are thousands of people on the street. We do need health rules. We do need safety rules. We do need parking rules. And we need everything to just sort of flow together and everyone to work together to make this a positive thing.
Whoa, that's cool. She even saved up a few pounds for
it.
Thank you.
Hey, this is beautiful. I'm honored to be painted. I mean, what can you say? That's the highest compliment you can have.
Now we gotta get you in the movies.
That's next. Thank you so much.
Sliders, and we got some pupusas, which are the best from this truck right here.
They're awesome.
What'd you get?
Got the tornado. Really good.
My goodness, I can't tell you enough. I'm so thrilled. I'm a native here, so I love this.
That's not right, letting them come in, take all the revenue. They've been here for 3-4 generations, you know? That's not right.
I would say the great majority of the people who come for the trucks are not interested in handicrafts and in knitting. Therefore, they take a quick glance and walk past.
Granada Hills Chamber of Commerce got together with several agencies, along with the food trucks, Department of Health, Police Department, Traffic and Safety, and we talked about issues regarding our Wednesdays and Fridays with the trucks. In general, most of the agencies felt that this was a good thing. Some people didn't. They're willing to work with the trucks.
My name is Terrence Powell. I'm with the Department of Public Health, the Environmental Health Division. Our major function is food protection. As far as the truck vendors with food, they're required to have access to restrooms if they stay stationary for more than 1 hour. And of course, they have to prepare and hold food in a safe manner. And we'll be there to ensure that.
Wednesday night after the meeting, and we had the health department hit Chatsworth in force. I believe there were up to 10 agents out inspecting all the trucks on both sides of the street.
There's one right there walking by. There's probably 5 or 6 of them out here tonight. They're working overtime, pretty much hitting every truck. We just got inspected, got a 96, got our A. They were nice, but serious. I heard a few of my friends got closed down for various reasons, which is kind of sad, but it's about public safety, and we have to be abiding by the laws and doing the things that it takes to be out here.
Pink champagne all night, and she said, we are all just prisoners here of our own device. And in the master chambers, gathered for the feast, stab it with their stealing eyes, but they just can't kill the beast.
I think that it has the potential to really revitalize the community and make our commercial district more of a vibrant retail district than it is currently. It's something that a lot of people have talked about. I think in order for that to happen, it needs to be managed somewhat. I think that if it's managed improperly or if it's not managed at all, it will eventually burn itself out.
Glad that some of the local, you know, merchants very supportive of this, not like some other, you know, area that we've been to, but it's kind of fortunate. Of course, you know, we have to work as a team, make this work, and, you know, bring this venue, you know, one of the hottest spots in the valley.
Hey, I heard Paul at the bakery's going to open tonight.
Really?
Yeah, let's go check it out.
I heard you might be opening up tonight.
Not tonight. Not tonight, soon, I hope.
These changes in attitudes, changes in attitude, nothing remains quite the same.
This is our new boutique. It's called Très Jolie. Yeah, we opened last week. It's a children's boutique filled with European clothes. We range from newborn to 6 years old. Well, we've lived in this area for a while, and it's never been as busy as it's been since the food trucks have been here. It's brought great attention to the street, and when we were looking for a location, it just seemed to fit ideally for the target market that we had and the age group and the kind of customers we were looking for. It just seemed like a perfect fit.
We're very excited about the new stores that have come into the area. I think it's a natural reaction to the number of people that have been coming out to this event.
I don't know what they do. They put in the cheese, the bread. I don't know what it is, but it's delicious.
This is the first time we came. Somebody recommended it to us, and we decided to stop by and try it for ourselves, and it was excellent.
We're going to get the killer combo.
And truffle fries.
Yeah, truffle fries. Something we've never had before.
The Chambers of Commerce, I haven't seen any changes so far. I mean, they've been telling me that, you know, they're working on it. You know, it's been already 3-4 months, almost like gave up already because there's not much I can do.
Well, the chamber's implementing a plan to centralize the issuance of the bathroom letters, which the trucks need in order to operate here. And the purpose of that is to create a focal point where all the trucks come in where we can, well, among other things, collect funds for handling the street cleaning and the trash pickup, hopefully deal with the parking issues that have been vexing some of the merchants here, with the goal being to keep this event going for a long time to come.
This thing is natural, it happened naturally. If you try to force people to either pay, you know, money and control this situation, you're gonna end up, you know, the truck owners are gonna end up leaving. So you're gonna kill the situation.
I don't think it's a long future, but for what period that it is popular, I think we ought to find a way to get along with each other.
Hey, where we go? We're at right outside the front door of Post 2323. We're letting all the customers from here just come on and enjoy the post. It's a charity event. We're not charging any admission, but we're letting them come in. And we have a live band on the back patio for free. There's no cover charge. They can buy something if they want, and if they don't want to, they don't have to. What we do is we get increased awareness. Usually brings in a few new members from the neighborhood that are already qualified veterans, but didn't really know we're here, because we're getting thousands of people down here that don't normally come to this part of town. I think this is absolutely wonderful for our community to have all these people coming here, never seen anything like this before, to change the whole character of our neighborhood here. It's really livening the place up, makes it a great meeting place.
It reminds me of kind of like a fair, street fair.
Yes, the people are coming in.
It's like the world's biggest food court.
Maybe some of these truck owners will end up opening a restaurant here that we can, you know, all enjoy.
I'm leaning right now towards it's actually good for us rather than it's bad for us right now.
We can't recognize the street from what it used to be and what it is now. It's unbelievable.
We're still eating.
Hope we give you guys the best service.
We've got the best community in the whole city, right here in Granada Hills. Granada Hills, the place to be.
If we have order and the community is liking it, I see that it will continue.
A lot of people, a lot of energy. It should be like this like every weekend. That would be great.
We sold out of everything, even drinks, sodas, waters, everything, fish, shrimp, everything, you name it, we sold out of everything.
We're on fire, baby. We're on fire. It's not stopping. 10 o'clock at night. Maybe one of these days I'll get to go back to sleep.
You cannot win, then you join them.
Best shish kebab at Ani Bakery.
Pretty busy out there.
When you have too many competition, you're gonna kick their ass. Crazy, man. I'm dead already. I'm so tired. You don't believe it.